I know we have a lot of questions, Capamilia, so I have called on Dr. Jasmine Eugenio of the Los Angeles Department of County Health Services to answer a few of the questions that we may have when it comes to childhood vaccines and just where we are in the pandemic. So thanks for joining us again, Dr. Eugenio. You know, what are some of the first things that our Kababayan should know as we enter this this new, it looks like it's a new phase in the pandemic. Hopefully it's the tail end of it, right?
That's correct. Well, we're hoping that it's going to be the tail end, but we always tell everyone that asks us that COVID is going to be around for a while. The biggest thing, as you all know, is that we are starting to vaccinate all children between the ages of 12 to 15 years old. It's the Pfizer vaccine. It's not much different from what adults are getting. It's pretty much the same. And it's the same dose, and it's the same number of days, which is 21 days between the first dose and the second dose. If your children are between the ages of 16 to 17 years old, they have to have consent. They can come with an adult, but if that's not possible, they have to have the consent from the parents. And you have to have the specific consent form, and you can get that from vaccinatelacounty.com.
Okay.
And then for 12 to 15 years old, they definitely have to have someone with them and a consent form. Now, the consent form should indicate the name of the person that's with them. So the person that's going with the child should also bring their ID.
What could you say to the kids that might be scared of the shots? And there's a number of anti-vaxxer parents out there that don't want their kids to get any vaccines at all.
So every time your child gets a vaccine, whether it's a COVID vaccine or any other vaccine, you have to let them know the day before. So get them prepared, tell them what they're getting, what it's going to be like. So just let them know you may have pain in your arm, and then the next day you may have tiredness or other symptoms, but it doesn't last long. It only lasts for 12 to 24 hours. Now, with regard to vaccine hesitancy, this is all I could say. In order for us to take care of our children, let them be vaccinated, we have to be good examples. We have to have the vaccine ourselves. We can't just expect the children to be getting the vaccine when we don't.
Hopefully this can give people the right information for when they make the choice to go out and vaccinate. Stay safe. Enjoy the what I guess we're expecting an influx of patients in the coming days. Maraming salamat, Doc.